Hey, hi, hello. So we are back in my garage for another video, and today we are going to be talking about running ethanol in our modern BMW engine. This applies for B58, S58. I mean, it's a pretty standard thing for BMW cars currently. And I'm gonna get on my soapbox a little bit here because I've talked about this before, posted multiple videos about it, but I still see people asking, what do I need to run ethanol? And they're getting mixed answers that are wrong, misinformed, incorrect, whatever you want to call it. And I know everybody hasn't seen my videos. Most B58 owners don't even know who I am, but I do want to try to do my part to help spread the good word of how easy it is to run ethanol in our cars. So we're going to go ahead and talk about it again. I know I'll probably be talking about it again in 6 months to a year, but hopefully this reaches a new audience, especially those of you that are kind of new subscribers and maybe haven't seen my old videos. We'll just clarify a few things about running ethanol in our cars so that you are very clear on what's actually needed to take advantage of E85. So let's go ahead and talk about it, and hopefully you guys find this video useful. Now, as always, for everybody that's new to the channel, I create these videos to help keep you updated on the latest developments in our community, as well as discuss technical topics so that we have a better understanding of how our engines work. So if you're interested in more videos like that, be sure to subscribe because there will be a lot more coming out in the future. Now, before we jump into this, let's just make sure we all have the same level of base knowledge. So let's quickly talk about E85. We like to take advantage of E85 because it is basically cheap, readily available race gas. Some of you know race gas is out there over 100 octane or whatever you would want, but you have to order it online, you know, wait for it to ship, it'll come to your house in barrels, and you kind of have to manage all of that, so it's a lot more difficult. Whereas with E85, you can get it directly at your gas pump, and compared to race gas, that's typically over $8 a gallon, E85 can be less than $3 a gallon, and just something that you can fill up and go. So it's really nice to use because it also has really high octane. It's much higher than 93 octane pump gas, so you can make more power with it. However, E85 is more corrosive than pump gas, and it also requires more fuel to run safely. So whereas the stoichiometric ratio for pump gas is around 14.7 to 1, on E85 it's typically around 9.8 to 1. So you end up needing about 30% more fuel flow on E85 to make the same power as a pump gas setup. So with that in mind, there are a lot of concerns out there. A lot of people are worried about what you need to safely run E85 and make that extra horsepower without potentially leaning out your engine or damaging components, messing up your fuel system, and stuff like that. Now, as far as me, for those of you that are curious, I have a 440i that has had ethanol tuning options since 2019. That's when it came out on boot mode and MHD. So that means I've been using E85 since 2019. As soon as it became available, I started running it in my car. So I've been running E85 for the past 5 years, everything from an ethanol mix to full E85, everything from stock turbo to an upgraded turbo with an upgraded fuel system back and forth. I've tried a lot of different things. So all of this feedback is coming from my personal experience as well as data that's been shared with other owners in the community. So with that in mind, I can confidently tell you that you only need three things that I would recommend in order to run E85 safely in your car. The first and most important thing, and really the only modification that you need to run E85, is an ethanol tune. Now this tune can be set for any amount of ethanol. It can be set for E30, E50, full E85, whatever it is, but you need that tune to dial in your setup for an ethanol mix or running full E85. This is important because it does set the base amount of fueling that you need for whatever amount of ethanol you're running. And like I said, you need up to 30% or more if you're trying to make more power with an E85 tune. So that's why this is probably the most critical thing to make sure you have. I would not just slap in a bunch of E85 on a stock tune. Make sure you get a tune that's designed for ethanol and then run the ethanol mix or the full E85 that it's designated for. Now, most people have E85 pumps available, but the ethanol content in those pumps will vary. It can be up to E85, but it can be as low as E50 and still be sold as E85. So that's why I recommend two additional things to make sure that you're running the right amount of ethanol for your tune setup. So the first thing is an actual test kit, and I just realized I forgot mine, so let me go grab it. All right, so This is my E85 test kit, and it comes in a little vial just like this. I got mine from Fuelit, so I will have a link down in the description if you want to buy the same one that I got. But this kit measures the amount of ethanol in your gas. So you can use this for E85. You basically fill it up with water to the first line, and then fill it up with fuel to the second line. And the trick here is pretty simple. Water mixes with alcohol. It does not mix with gas. So as it mixes, it'll create a line here, and that line will tell you how much ethanol you have in your fuel, and then everything on top is just gas. So this can tell you everything from E0 up to basically E99, I guess, everything up to a full amount of 100% ethanol. And this is really important, again, just to validate how much ethanol is in the E85 at your gas station. Again, it can be down as low as E50 and still sold as E85, so you can't just rely on somebody saying 3 gallons of E85, 5 gallons of pump gas, or whatever they might tell you. You need to measure it yourself to make sure that you're getting your mix right. This also works for pump gas because, as you guys should know, pump gas can have ethanol in it as well. It can be up to E10. So I've even used this for my pump gas. Again, water, pump gas, fill it up, and your E5 or E10, whatever, should show down here so you know exactly how much ethanol is in your pump gas. And you can use that to calculate your ethanol mix. So this is really cheap and really important to make sure you're getting your ethanol mix correct. And then the last thing you need is a calculator app. So this is something we pretty much just download on our phones. You go to your preferred app store, play store, whatever, and download an ethanol calculator app. Now I recommend finding one that lets you put in a specific amount of fuel that's in your tank. So like a set amount of gallons and tell it how many gallons your tank has. So that way it can be as accurate as possible. Some of them just use sliders and try to go off of, you know, your fuel gauge reading, so quarter tank, half tank, whatever, and it's not really as accurate. We can go into the hidden menu on our cars and see exactly how much fuel is in our tank, and that gives you the best opportunity to calculate your ethanol mix accurately. So that's why I like to use one that lets me specify exactly how many gallons of fuel I have, as well as the capacity of my fuel tank, and that lets me calculate the ethanol mix accurately. So those things are really all you need. That's what I used on my 440i back in 2019. That was before we had any upgrades available, which we'll talk about a little bit, but these are the minimum requirements that I would say anybody needs in order to run ethanol. So with that being said, let's talk about the upgrades, because now we're hearing people say all of these things that you need to run E85 that we didn't have available in 2019. So how were we able to do it back then without all of these other kits and upgrades? The first and probably most popular one that we hear nowadays is you need a flex fuel kit in order to run E85. And that, of course, is absolutely not the case. What I like to say is it's kind of like a TPMS sensor in your tires. It doesn't make you fill up the right amount of air in your tire. It just tells you if your tire pressure is wrong. And that's basically the same thing a flex fuel kit or a flex fuel sensor is going to do. By the time it's getting a reading and you're driving away, all it's going to do is tell you if you got the measurement right or wrong. You absolutely still need the test kit to measure how much ethanol is coming out of your pump and a calculator app or some tool to calculate how much ethanol you need to pump in order to get your ethanol mix right. The benefit with an actual flex fuel kit is that you can actually set up your tune to automatically adjust even if you get your mix wrong. So if you're trying to get an E50 mix but it ends up at E45 or E55, it will make sure it adjusts boost and timing in your tune so that you don't have any issues with getting your mix wrong. So that's what I like to use. It definitely makes it more convenient and more safe, but it does not automatically make it so that you can calculate your mix right to get you an E50 or E30 or whatever you're trying to target. So for me, I like it just because it's more convenient. And with all of my custom tunes now, I am flex fuel tuned just so I don't have to think about it. But again, back in 2019, even in 2020, we did not have these kits available. There were people making over 600 wheel horsepower on ethanol mixes doing it that exact way. So it's more important to make sure that you can calculate your mix and you know what you're pumping into your car versus having a sensor that just tells you after the fact. The other thing that I hear, of course, are a lot of fuel system upgrades that you need to run E85. So on Gen 1, everybody says you need a high pressure fuel pump. Again, absolutely not true. On a completely stock car, I ran full E85. I even posted a video showing you guys how much E85 the stock fuel system can handle, and how an appropriate tune can scale your boost and timing based on the amount of ethanol you have in your fuel tank. So it really is that simple. Every upgrade that you put on your car increases how much power your car can make, and the same thing applies for ethanol. Typically, the perfect ethanol mix where you make the most power is around E30 to E50. So that's why a lot of people like to target in that range so that they can optimize how much fuel flow they have in their fuel system while still getting a good amount of timing and boost to make good power. But if you go up to full E85, all you need to do is dial back boost. Usually you can still raise up timing a little bit more to land in the middle, and you'll end up with a car that's still faster than pump gas, but safely making enough boost and timing that it doesn't overwhelm your fuel system compared to an ethanol mix. So that's why I kind of struggle with people saying, oh, above E30, your stock fuel pump can't handle it, or above E50. That just means that you're running too much boost. That just means that your tune isn't designed for full E85. But if you have a tune for full E85, it'll work without an issue. Now, the same thing goes for upgraded injectors or port injection, because there will be a limit. You know, when I was just on my TU pump and I had a big turbo setup running ethanol, I was limited to like the low 20s, around 22 or 23 PSI. This was still faster than the stock turbo on ethanol, so I was really enjoying it. But once I upgraded and added port injection, I was able to run more boost and make even more power. So again, from this standpoint, it's not really a limitation where you can't run E85 without upgrading injectors or adding port injection. They just add more capacity so that your car can make more power. And it really depends on your setup, especially if you're just on an ethanol mix. Most people don't need injectors or port injection. All you need is like a Dorch Stage 2 high pressure fuel pump, and you can make over 600 wheel horsepower without an issue. But if you want to run it on full E85, that's when it becomes more taxing on your fuel system, and you'll have to upgrade more components to get those same horsepower numbers. It really just depends on your goals and what you want to run. And then the last thing that a lot of people say is a low pressure fuel pump, which is pretty much the last thing you're going to need to upgrade. After you've upgraded your high pressure fuel pump and your injectors, the low pressure fuel pump is probably close to running to its limits next. So that's usually something that people upgrade afterwards. But that definitely is not a requirement for E85. Running E85 doesn't automatically burn up your fuel pump. I've heard it burns up EKPs and makes it run at full load all the time and all this stuff. So again, I've been running my stock low pressure fuel pump for years with E85 before I upgraded it to support higher horsepower levels at higher ethanol content. That's really the only reason I upgraded it, but it does not automatically die or run out of fuel just because you're putting E85 in your fuel tank. So yeah, the main thing around here is understanding that running E85 doesn't automatically overwhelm things. You need to build your car around your goals. Determine what kind of ethanol you want to run, how much ethanol you want to run, how much power you want to make, and then you need to put your supporting mods around that. So that's why both of my cars now have port injection and flex fuel and all of that stuff, because I don't want to worry about mixing. I want to be able to run full E85, but I still want to be able to make the same amount of power that I was making on E40 and E50. So I added all of these different things for my own convenience, so I can just fill up with E85 and drive away. When it's winter and I want to run pump gas, I can just fill up with pump gas and drive away, and absolutely nothing changes. So it's really about you. I know there are plenty of people making just as much power with me with probably half the money invested, simply because they don't mind using a little $20 test kit to calculate their ethanol mix at the gas pump. And that is perfectly fine too. If you just want to tune your car on E40 or E50, you'd be surprised how fast it can be compared to a car like mine that's full E85 and a bunch of supporting mods just to make the same power because I'm being lazy. So hopefully this makes sense to you guys. It's E85 is actually a really nice option for a lot of us. Our cars love the additional octane, and our fuel systems and everything are designed to be able to support it, as we have been testing for the past 5+ years now. So just wanted to answer that question one more time. Again, I know we'll be talking about this again in the future, so stick around for that. But I think that is it for this video. So thank you guys for watching, and I hope this helps. And if you have any other questions or comments, leave them down below. So in my 440i, I've been running everything from E30 to full E85 on stock turbo and pump turbo.